This is our PCBA facility. What we do is we do a really high-end product, like very complexity of the product from PCB, PCBA, box build, cable assembly, and also repair services. That is our expertise. So as you can see here, this is the box build area. You know, we build some kind of server box for a very high-end customer from US only. So we are the only vendor qualified to build a high-end product in Vietnam, especially the server. You can see the ball level right there.
Yeah.
Another complicated box build that only we can handle this unit from US. It's I cannot publish the customer name, but
it's military.
This really tell us how complicated it's inside.
See, military connector, for example.
It's a military. He's right. There's a lot of other system we've been built, and on this side is all of the touch up, rework, assembly, cable, box build happening in this area. Also, this SMT area on the other side, right? So this is a cable assembly we build in upstairs. So we have two full SMT line. You know how complicated board that we build. This is more than 1,000 component on board.
Very complex.
It's many complexity of the component package, right? So it's not too many supplier can handle this kind of, you know, complicated board in Vietnam nowadays, right? So, but we are from US company, and we have a division in Vietnam. That's why the technical between engineering, sharing all of the information. That's why Vietnam right now fully authorized to build any high-end product for US. This is one of our AOI inspection.
Yeah.
So this little ball, when it comes to AOI called optical inspection. So what it needs, what it does, what it do is, it capture the image, you know, within 7 seconds to know if there any component problem, upside down orientation, you know, not very good, sort of joint not good. So it detect all kind of assembly issue before it go to next step. So this machine is do the job within 7 seconds. Let's say this one is about 1,000 pin, 1,000 I/O. So it capture 1,000 snapshot. So the software gonna analyze every single one of them, just to make sure, hey, you are within spec or you out of the spec. Mm-hmm. So in order for us to do this, it's require a lot of engineering time. We prepare the data 2 days, but it only takes 7 seconds to inspect. So this is called an oven profile. You know, before the oven profile is meaning any board level that we want to put the component on board and attack the component, you know, to the board, is required, you know, to heat up the solder paste. Like the solder paste that is solid, form all the component attached to the board. So that's why, in order for the component attached to the board, this oven duty is need to create a temperature, a hot temperature. So the temperature is not just the temperature, but this oven also have every joint, every controller to control the temperature, ramp up slowly, cool down slowly, just to make sure, you know, we don't have any shocking. It's a lot of issue behind if we don't do it right. So in order for the engineer to make the board right, it will take about at least 3 to 4 days to run the sample, to make sure the profile is steady, to make sure everything is within the spec. Within the spec meaning within the component spec, within the solder paste spec, within the PCB spec. So it's combined the information apply to this guy and tell this guy, hey, this is my spec. Any ball run through have a problem, it, now we know that the process problem. This device will not tell the difference, only the AOI optical inspection will tell you the defect rate. So the yield for us right now is about 99.5%. We still have 0.5% fall out due to, you know, some of the solder out of life, some of the components become oxidized, some of the PCB swapping. So a lot of factors add on to become an issue. So, but when we have the issue, it's go to that last step to detect all of the issue before, you know, we move on to the next step or before the finished good board to put in the system, right? So we have a checkpoint inspection from every single step we do, right? So this is a pick and play machine. So this is all the feeder, you know, loading the component. You can see all of the feeder, you know, fit in the machine. So it pick the component, put in the ball. So the ball go to the oven. So attack the component. So this is the solder paste. So you can see it's printing the solder paste right now. So it put the ball up. So now it's printing. That's the very first step. So this is an empty ball right here. So it's printing the solder paste on the pass side just to make sure, you know, the requirement of solder paste on ball. It's a lot of complication. When you see it's very simple, a few seconds you see it done. You can see how tiny of the pin. We cannot have a solder bridging. We cannot have more solder. So it has to be a sack. Why it can be a sack? Based on the spec requirement. Based on the IPC spec. Say, hey, my thickness about 4 or 3 mil. That's it. If you 5 mil, you out. Or you less than 2 mil, you out. So this guy doing the job, but this guy doing the inspection. So this called, you know, SPI, solder paste inspection. So this SPI will check the solder, you know, after printing, every single one of them. So we have a better machine, they call, you know, Accra. So this machine can turn on a 2D inspection. That means, you know, when it's printing, it turn on the inspection by itself.
So combine the SPI. Printing and
yeah, you
SPI,
can see
yeah.
This, we have SPI.
Yeah,
true. Because this machine is too old.
Yeah.
So, but this machine is newer version. So it do two jobs. Printing, inspect,
yeah.
Pass. But in order to say very easy, right? But the engineer have to put a lot of effort, a lot of thinking, enter into this kind of requirement, criteria, tolerance, you see. So we have to put the set of pads on here just to make sure, you know, every single one of them have a set of pads printing from this machine. This is how we make PCB, very first step, design. So in order for the engineer order the stencil, it will take about a few hours just to study the data, to study the assembly, before you can order the stencil. It's not just like you go buy from outside, no. It's require a lot of engineering. So this is how we produce the ball, right? It's go through everything, it's becoming the ball right here. But in order to get to here, it requires 20 years experience. Knowledge. Minimum. Minimum. I'm talking about minimum 20 years.
Okay.
To make this kind of complicated.
Yeah.
Connector, meet the connector, all kind of component on ball. But you make that simple ball, it requires 5 years. You make this kind of ball, it requires 20 years. Everybody can do it, but defect rates, it's huge. Reliability of the quality is totally different from people who know what to do and who doesn't know what to do. It's not just you have the best equipment in house, you can do anything. No, it's not this kind of technology. It requires knowledge. So now, with this machine, you can see it's reflow pin by pin is replacing all of these people. If you spend 20 people to do hand solder.
I have never seen.
Yeah. So this is called selective wave solder.
Yeah.
If we select single point of it to solder, but when it's solder, the accuracy is the best.
What is the size of the pin?
It's about within 25 mil.
25, okay.
Yeah. We can go small size, we can use small needle.
Yeah, okay.
This technology is about 10 years ago, people start to get rid of human because human cannot control reliability. Human cannot control the timing when you do soldering. So, but this machine is control timing everything. So, and it's faster.
Very interesting that they are still creating technology for all the old true PCB components.
Still, you can see here. This is all two-hole component.
Yeah, there's lots.
Yeah, this is all two-hole component.
Why somebody is still doing through-hole components?
Well, you know, in the old day, people have a system like more than $1 million. The design no longer good, The machine down, you cannot throw the machine away.
Yeah.
30 year old, but one is the ball going down.
Yeah.
That's kind of ball.
Okay.
Where? You have to remake it.
Yeah.
You cannot buy a new machine. Every time, right? So if the ball down, so that's why the two-hole components still exist in the world. So this is our best showcase. You're talking about building the assembly all day long, but how do you know your assembly is good to go into the system? The only way, testing. So this is, the testing is we test open and short, we test input and output, we test functionality of component, we test 0.5% of the ball level. Just to ensure this ball coming out before it go into this kind of system, right? Mm. When it go to this system, it must be good. So that's how we conduct the test. You see, this testing is have top side and bottom side together. You can see that?
Flying probe. It's called flying probe.
Yeah.
The programming for this, is the customer or you?
No, we do.
Based on what?
Based on the schematics. The schematics and the CAD file.
Okay.
The CAD file, we make the stencil. We the one who program everything.
Okay.
So every ball, like this kind of complicated ball, we take the engineer about 2 days. But a simple ball take about 4 hours to program it.
Yeah.
So we program based on the CAD file, on the design, schematics, and also some of the information randomly from the bomb, the bill of material, input and output, open and soft and component value.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. So we enter those kind of import the bomb into the software.
You are testing functionality, but not the result. So you are testing every component's functionality.
Each of the component on board have its functionality.
Yeah.
To go to one of the channel or signal, right? And then it becoming output of the board. So and then, but that's just the board level. But we're talking about system level.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
When it's going here, so now we have a functionality of a system functionality.
Yeah.
So it's going to the system. So it makes sure all the cable, all the connection, it talk, this ball talk to this ball talk to the other ball. So that's called system test. System test is the final line, you know, before we ship the product to customer for usage. When it's installed here, it may come out with failure.
Yeah.
We don't know, but you know, that's why our expertise, not only just build the ball, but also analyze everything. So we are becoming the first supplier in Vietnam can handle this kind of complicated ball. When I'm here about a year, I bring up the revenue up to 40%. We expand to another building. So another building is dedicated for a giant customer. Now you can go to PCB. Let's go. Come in here. So look at our inventory warehouse. A lot of components that we stock. Why? We only build 10 or 20 units. Mm. It requires all material have to be ready in house.
Yeah.
We're not building a million or a half thousand.
Yeah.
So our stock room is kind of turnkey business. Turnkey business meaning we buy material for customer, put into the system, complete unit, 10 or 20. So this along is about mostly $20 million for all this stock room. But 50% is from our customer. They the one have to issue the PO to us.
Yeah.
Right? And then we charge the stock, you know, space. But this, I still feel very small. That's why I moved to the next building, the bigger building. Okay. So this is our new customer. Mm. We just landed a very good, giant, big customer ever before. That's one of the reasons we're going to expand to a bigger building than this 3 times. So this is our special cable assembly.
Okay.
You name it.
So you do cable assembly, but it's only for the products you are building up?
No.
Also for external?
For external.
Ah, okay.
You know, this is all of the design. This is also
the template toolings.
Yeah. For each of the cable, we have, you know, the best measurement. It's sometimes faster than the machine.
Yeah.
The good thing is, everything we do is online for work instruction. Mm. You know, all the operators have a clear detail.
Yeah.
What to do, how to do. And for escalation or some kind of issue with the technical issue or any problem, we're doing the time that they assemble it. So that's why the engineer will control from online, everything. No, I don't like paper. Yeah. So you look here, it's more clean, right?
Yeah.
So is that better?
Yeah.
Right? Why nowadays people using paper? No. In my world, less paper is the less habit. International standard.
IPC, okay.
Yeah, IPC. And not only we qualify, but we have a trainer and trainer in-house. So we train our own employees.
Are you still qualified for training?
I am.
Yeah. Down and I'ma get it right, then I'll fight like